So today we're going to be reading Kurt Cobain Nirvana related fan fiction from Wattpad. I looked a lot into it, but it's a lot of fan fictions where girls fall in love with Kurt Cobain or something like that. Nope. So I bookmarked the ones in here that are the most interesting ones, basically. So I'm gonna start off with this one's called 50 Shades of Kurt Cobain. Yeah. He flicks the cigarette stub into the ground, pulls out another one before answering. I told you, I'm Kurt Cobain. Or at least I'm the ghost of myself, haha. Hence the reason why that the guard couldn't see me. I'm sorry, but I'm just a little bit skeptical. Don't worry, you're not the only one. So you've done this before, I asked? I mean, I've been able to feel your hand on me, but how does that work? I haven't quite figured out everything, but I only appear to people that I desire, and yes, I can touch you. I saw you and instantly knew I wanted you. Not exactly understanding what he means, I wait for him to go on. When he doesn't, I inquire, what do you mean by I knew I wanted you? This time I can clearly tell he winked at me. I'd love the opportunity to spend the night with you, showing you that ghosts can still fuck hard. Okay. Shocked, I take a step back and quickly snap my jaw back into place. It has dropped. When he said he wanted to fuck me, you didn't mean that, I gasp. He throws down his half-smoked cigarette and gently pulls his warm body to mine. Oh, but I do. Let me show you a good time. This is a Kurt Cobain and Dave Grohl one. I don't know why people ship them a lot together, but whatever. Kurt looked at me with his beautiful blue eyes. Okay, Dave, go ahead. You know I'm always listening. And that was true. Kurt always listened, and he was very understanding. Well, Kurt, I know we've been friends for a long time, even like brothers, but Kurt, I love you. I closed my eyes knowing Kurt probably wouldn't say nothing and probably just walk away and never talk to me again, but I was surprised that he did. Dave, I've loved you for a long time. I just didn't want to say nothing because I thought maybe you would, I don't know, never talk to me again. I looked at Kurt and smiled. Kurt, I would never do anything to hurt you, and you know that. You can always trust me. Kurt looked at me and smiled. God, he was so beautiful. His beautiful hair, beautiful blue eyes, and beautiful skin, creamy pale skin. I know, Dave. I'd never do anything to hurt you. I kissed Kurt on the cheek. So does this mean, we're dating? I mean, if you don't want to, but Kurt cut me off and kissed my lips gently and quick. I want to, Dave. I want to be with you forever. I smiled and I finally was the most beautifulest person in the world and the person who made me happy. I kissed Kurt on his forehead. Good, Kurt. Yeah, I love you, babe. Kurt blushed a little and it was adorable. I love you too, Dave. Oh my God. That escalated pretty quickly for a first chapter. Yeah. That was like probably the most scandalous fan fictions I could find online. All the rest of them were just about girls falling in love with Kurt Cobain, which were pretty boring, so I didn't care about those. But yeah, so I wrote my own Nirvana fanfic. So here it goes. Chris was walking in the corridor and bumps into you. You drop your bag. Chris picks it up and starts beating you with it. You go into a coma. And then another one. Kurt ends his set trashing the instruments. He tells you to come on stage, and he orders you to stand still and close your eyes. He has a surprise for you. Kurt hits you over the head with his guitar. The audience laughs. You die. The end. Oh, this one is for all the Dave and Kurt shippers out there. So here it is. Dave gets close to Kurt's face. Kurt stabs him. And then the last one is, Courtney burps loudly. She burps so loud that she swallows herself. The end. I think I write the best Nirvana fanfiction, if I could write Nirvana fanfiction, you know. I mean, mines were like way more realistic, you know, like they should get awards. Yeah. So I'll see you next time. Bye.